Let us continue. Solid state ZNS system we'll consider. In this, first we'll see tetrahedron. For tetrahedron, we'll take methane. Methane is the example. In the methane, we can say central atom is carbon. Here one nitrogen atom. Okay, so it is methane. Methane is an example for tetrahedral structure. Now you see, in the place of this hydrogen, we are considering this corner. In the place of this hydrogen, we are considering this top face center. In the place of this hydrogen, it is in front of you, this hydrogen. That is a front face center we'll consider. This is a rear. This hydrogen is rear. That is a left face center we'll take. This carbon is at center. That center is here. Okay. So now see, we are, this is in small cube. In this FCC unit cell, this is a top left front small cube. In this small cube, one is corner, second one is top face center, third one is front face center, fourth one is this left side face center. Now, from this corner, we are drawing a line to the center of this small cube. From this center, we are drawing line to this front face center. From this center, we are drawing a line to this left side face center. Now you say, this is this. Is it like tetrahedron? First, we have to conclude that whether it is tetrahedron or not. First, you say, what is the shape of this one? Do you say this corner? And these three face centers we considered. Now, what is the shape of this one, do you say? Do you say that it is a tetrahedron or not? It is not tetrahedron, it is some other structure. Methane is tetrahedral, we know. Okay, surrounding of tetrahedron, hydrogens are there. Surrounding is four, hydrogens are there. Here what is four means, one is corner, second is this top face center, third is front face center, fourth is this left side face center. For this methane, center point, center what is there means carbon is there. That center point is here, at center point what will be there, that we will say later. Okay, this center point is this place. Now, we have joined the lines here, is it tetrahedron or not? What do you say regarding this? First you say this, is it tetrahedron or it is not a tetrahedron? What do you say regarding this? Will you say it is tetrahedron or not? Respond it. Will you say this is a tetrahedral structure or some other structure do you say? What structure it is? If you say this one, then only we can proceed to next. Sorry. You are saying that it is a tetrahedral, you are saying. Now you say this center point is called tetrahedral void, do you say? Or what void do you say? Okay, you are saying that this is tetrahedral void. In the tetrahedral void, we will place Zn2+. Okay. In the corner, what we have to place means sulfide. sulfide we have to place in the corner because sulfide forms FCC. Okay, so sulfide forms FCC. Sulfide forms FCC. So in the corner we have to keep sulfide. So in the corner we have to keep sulfide. In this face center we have to keep sulfide. In this face center we have to keep sulfide. In this face center also we have to keep sulfide. So now this Zn2+ is in contact with how many sulfide ions you think it? Then you say coordination number of zinc ion. Coordination number means that is in contact with how many of its neighbors. It is ionic compound. Ionic compound means cation coordination number we have to say using anions. Anion coordination number we have to say using cations. Okay. So now zinc is there in the tetrahedral void. This zinc is in contact with corner sulfide. Then corner top face center. This zinc is in contact with the sulfide face center top. This zinc is in contact with the front face center sulfide. This zinc is in contact with the left side face center sulfide. Now zinc is in contact with how many sulfide ions? From that you say coordination number of zinc ion. What is the coordination number of zinc ion do you say? What is the coordination number of zinc ion? Sir. Sorry. Now we are taking sulfide forms FCC. Okay. Sulfide forms FCC means in the corner sulfide will be there. In the front face center sulfide will be there. Top face center sulfide will be there. Left side face center sulfide will be there. Sorry. Using these four particles can we draw tetrahedron? That we'll see. Now from this corner we will go to center of the cube, small cube. From the center of the small cube we will go to top face center. From the center of the small cube we will go to left side face center. From the center of the small cube we will go to front side face center. Okay, now we got tetrahedron. In this tetrahedral void we will write zinc ion. Now you say this zinc ion, is it in contact with this sulfide? Yes, because it is void. This void is created by these four sulfide ions. These four sulfide ions are creating this tetrahedral void. These four sulfide ions are in contact with each other. These four sulfide ions are in contact with each other. Due to them, this void is created. In that void is what is there, means tetrahedral void. Tetrahedral void, in that zinc ion is there. Zinc ion is there. Okay. So first we will see how tetrahedron will be there. How tetrahedral void will be there. That we will see. Then we will come to this point. Now you see, you are given a tetrahedron. You are given tetrahedron here. You see this is a tetrahedron. In the first layer, three blue color balls are there. In the second layer, this orange yellow ball is there. In between the second layer orange yellow and first layer blue, this place is called a void, that is called tetrahedral void. You lift to the second layer, orange yellow, you can see this tetrahedral void. So how this tetrahedral void is there? See, this tetrahedral void is enclosed by four particles. These four particles are in contact with each other. These four particles, they are in contact with each other. So this place is called tetrahedral void. Now you say this tetrahedral void is in contact with these four particles or not? This tetrahedral void is due to these four particles. This tetrahedral void is formed due to these four particles. That means this tetrahedral void is enclosed by these four particles. This tetrahedral void is enclosed by these four particles. In this tetrahedral void, what is there? Means zinc ion is there. Now we can say that this is what means sulfide. This blue color ball is sulfide. That blue color ball is what means sulfide. This is sulfide. This orange color ball also sulfide. Here tetrahedral void will be there, no? Here tetrahedral void. In this tetrahedral void, what is there means zinc is there. In this tetrahedral void, what is there means zinc is there. Okay, so that we will see now. Now we will see here. Okay, now we have taken so this is a corner sulfide. This is face center sulfide. This is front face center sulfide. This is left side face center sulfide. These four sulfide ions forming a tetrahedron. In the center of that tetrahedral void is there zinc ion is there. Now the question is, zinc ion is in contact with how many sulfide ions? So what is the coordination number of zinc ion? That is the question. What is the coordination number of a zinc ion? What shall we say? Coordination number of zinc ion. Coordination number of zinc ion is how much? Sir, do you say that zinc ion will be in contact with any more sulfide ions also? Do you say that zinc ion is in contact with any more sulfide ions? For that, you say that tetrahedron means that is in the cube. In the cube only tetrahedron is there. Where tetrahedron is there means that is in the cube. Now you see, this tetrahedron is given. Tetrahedron is there. Where it is there means in the cube. Tetrahedron is there in the cube. Okay, so it is a cube. In the cube, tetrahedron is there. Tetrahedron means four triangles will be there. Four triangles are there. It is tetrahedron at center. Center point is called tetrahedral void. So tetrahedron is there in the cube. So tetrahedral void is nothing but a body center of this cube. Tetrahedral void is nothing but body center of this cube. So tetrahedral void belongs to only this cube. So tetrahedral void will be in contact with how many? That you see. If the tetrahedral void will be in contact with how many particles? That you think and say. So here, now we will take this one. Okay. Here you see these sulfide ions, these four sulfide ions forming tetrahedron. So this is a void. This void is called tetrahedral void. In this tetrahedral void, zinc is there. Now zinc is in contact with how many sulfide ions do you say? This zinc is in contact with how many sulfide ions do you say? Zinc is in contact with how many sulfide ions? how many sulfide ions? What shall we say? Zinc is in contact with how many sulfide ions? Shall we say? Shall we say 4 sulfide ions, or more than 4, or less than 4? Zinc is in contact with how many sulfide ions? Zinc, here the question is, zinc is in contact with how many sulfide ions? Shall we say 4, or greater than 4, or less than 4? What shall we say? Now, zinc is in contact with how many sulfide ions? How many sulfide ions in a FCC lattice? In a FCC lattice. Zinc is in contact with how many sulfide ions in a FCC lattice? One option, 4 sulfide ions. Next, greater than 4 sulfide ions. Third, less than 4 sulfide ions. Fourth, we are unable to see. What do you say regarding this? So you are saying that less than 4 sulfide ions you are saying. So one student says that less than 4 sulfide ions. Less than 4 sulfide ions means 3, 2, 1 like this. 3, 2, 1 like this. First, you are saying more than 4 sulfide ions. More than 4 sulfide ions you are saying. Sorry. That means clarity is not there. So we did not get a clear idea. Sorry, okay. Sorry. What shall we do? Sorry. First, we will write first we will take one small cube. What is that small cube means? We will take small cube like this. We'll take a small cube. We are taking a small cube like this. We'll take small cube, okay. In this small cube one we have taken. Now first we'll take what is that means? Corner we'll take. This is one particle. We'll take one sulfide here. Then next is sulfide. We'll take keep in alternative here. Next sulfide we'll keep here. In alternative place we have to keep. To get tetrahedral, like this we placed. So 4 particles we placed. Sir, next we will draw tetrahedron. So from this we will go to center point of the which one means this small cube. From this we will go to this place. From this we will go to this place. Okay, now is it tetrahedron? Now you say, is it tetrahedron? This center place is what means zinc ion. Zinc ion is there in this center place. In the center place, what is there means zinc ion is there. Now you say, this center place zinc ion is in contact with how many sulfide ions? You see, if these 4 sulfide ions are there, then only we will get tetrahedron. No, So tetrahedral void will be formed by how many particles do you see? You see this cube we have taken. In this cube, this orange is sulfide. Okay, this orange is what means? This orange is sulfide. This blue color is what means? This blue color is what means? Zinc. This blue color is zinc. This orange is what means? Sulfide. Orange is sulfide. This blue color is what means? Zinc. Blue color is what means? Zinc. Okay, so orange is sulfide we are saying, blue color is zinc we are saying. So this Zn2+ is in contact with this sulfide, number one. This Zn2+ is in contact with this second sulfide, number three. This Zn2+ is in contact with this third sulfide. This Zn2+ is in contact with this fourth sulfide. So now you say that this Zn2+ is in contact with how many sulfide ions you see? This Zn2+ is in contact with how many sulfide ions you see? Okay, that we will see here. In this place also we will see. Now this orange color means sulfide. This orange color sulfide will keep first. So here one sulfide, second sulfide corner, third sulfide corner, fourth sulfide corner, fifth sulfide corner, sixth sulfide corner, seventh sulfide corner, eighth sulfide corner. Then we will see face center sulfide, one face center, top face center, right side face center, bottom face center, front face center, then back face center. Now we will go for tetrahedral zinc. We will go. Now we will go for tetrahedral. Now I will take this front side, top left corner. I will take from that. I will go to center of the cube. From the center of the cube, I will go to top face center. I will go. From the center of the cube, small cube, I will go to front face center, front face center. From the center of the cube, I will go to left side face center. Now this is tetrahedron. We got tetrahedron. Now we will go for tetrahedral void. At tetrahedral void, what is there means zinc is present. At tetrahedral void, what is there means zinc is present. Now this tetrahedral void is nothing but a center of this small cube. Center of this small cube, that means like body center. Center of this small cube, tetrahedral void is there. Now shall we say tetrahedral void is in contact with this tetrahedral void means zinc. This zinc is occupied this place. This because void was there. This void created by whom? One this corner, second this face center, third this face center, fourth this face center. Due to these four sulfide ions only this void is created. In this void, what is there means zinc is there. Okay, so you say that coordination number of zinc is 4. Okay, you are saying that coordination number of zinc is 4. You are saying because zinc is in contact with 4 sulfide ions. Why to say 4? Zinc is occupying tetrahedral void. Tetrahedral void means for that surrounding is 4 only. No, methane is the example. Methane is tetrahedral. In methane, central atom is carbon. Carbon, for carbon, how many surrounding hydrogens? 4. So tetrahedral void means 4 is the coordination number. That's all. Okay, so tetrahedral void means 4 is the coordination number because its surrounding is 4. Okay, so zinc coordination number is what means? For zinc, what is the coordination number means? We can say 4. So for coordination number of zinc is 4, we said. Next we'll see coordination number of sulfide. We'll see coordination number of sulfide. We have to say Let us rub this one. Now we will go for a coordination number of a sulfide. We have to go. Sir, first we will keep where and all sulfide possibilities there. That we will keep. Sulfide forms FCC. So sulfide we will keep in corners. So we will in corners we will keep sulfide. Then we will keep sulfide in the face centers. We will keep sulfide in the face centers. Okay. We placed sulfide in the face centers. We placed. Then now sulfide forms FCC. That point is over. Sulfide forms FCC. That means sulfide ions occupies all the corners and all the face centers. That is over. Next we have to go for zinc ions. Sir, zinc ions occupy alternate tetrahedral voids. Zinc ions occupy alternate tetrahedral voids. That we will place. So we will place zinc ions. We will place. Okay. So we will place zinc ions. Sir, we are going to place zinc ions. So first we will take one tetrahedron. First we will draw tetrahedron. This corner will take. From this corner we will go to center of the small cube. From the center of the small cube we will go to this face center. From center of small cube we will go to this face center, front face center. From center of the small cube we will go to left side face center. Now we will place at center of this small cube tetrahedral void is there. At tetrahedral void we will place Zn2+. So tetrahedral void Zn2+ we placed. It is one. Next, Zn2+ occupies alternate tetrahedral voids. Zn2+ occupies alternate tetrahedral voids. Now we will take this corner. From this corner, we will go to center of the cube. Center of the cube. From this center of the cube, we will go to left side face center. From the center of the cube, we will go to top face center. From the center of the cube, we will go to backside face center. Now we got Zn2+ at this place. It is now Zn2+, where it is there means top, right side, back, small cube, center is the tetrahedral void. There Zn2+ is there. Why we have to keep there means in alternative tetrahedral voids only we have to keep Zn2+. Okay. Next, like this we can keep. Now you see, you take this sulfide. This sulfide is in contact with this Zn2+. This sulfide is in contact with this Zn2+. Okay. This sulfide is in contact with this Zn2+. Okay. So now we will say this sulfide is in contact with Zn2+. That we will see. Okay. So first, now we will take we are considering which sulfide means we are considering this sulfide. Okay. For that sulfide, this sulfide is forming. It is in contact with Zn2+. It is in contact with which Zn2+? Which Zn2+? Number one, left side, top, front small cube. That tetrahedral void is there. That I will show. I am pointing that tetrahedral void, that Zn2+. Next, number two, sulfide is in contact with which Zn2+? For that number two, right side, top, back, small cube. That I will point out. That Zn2+ I am pointing here. I am pointing with the arrow mark. That blue color Zn2+ I am pointing with the arrow mark. Okay. Now this sulfide. Now we will continue this FCC, in a lattice we will continue. For continuing, we will draw a cube like this. Here we will draw a cube. Okay, we have drawn a small cube. Now we will go for tetrahedron. Okay, we will keep sulfide. We will keep here we have to keep one sulfide. We will keep sulfide ions. We will keep, so sulfide ions we have to keep alternate. So one we will place here, one we placed. So one is this one, second one is this one, third one is this one, fourth one is this one. Okay, four sulfide ions we placed. Now we will draw tetrahedron, then we will go for tetrahedral void. Sir, let us go for tetrahedron. So from this we will draw a line to center of the small cube. From the center of the small cube, we will go to this place. From the center of the small cube, we will go to this place. From the center of the small cube, we will go to this place. Is it a tetrahedron or not? You see, this is a tetrahedron. So this center point is called a tetrahedral void. So this center point is called what means a tetrahedral void, that we will see. That is tetrahedral void here. That center point is called tetrahedral void. Okay, center point is called tetrahedral void, we say. In this tetrahedral void, what is there means Zn2 plus is there. Okay, so here one Zn2 plus is there. Next, alternative tetrahedron, no. Therefore, alternative we will see. Alternative. So we will draw a cube like this. Alternative tetrahedral void, therefore we'll draw a cube here. We'll draw a cube here. Okay, we have drawn a cube. We will place sulfides. Sulfide ions will place. Sulfide ions will place one. On the alternative, we have to place sulfide ions. Then here will place. Now we will go for tetrahedron. Now we are going for tetrahedron. From here we will go to center point. From the center point we will go to this. From the center point we will go to this place. From the center point, we will come to this place. Now we got tetrahedron. This is a tetrahedral void. In this tetrahedral void, what is there means Zn2 plus is there. Now you say this sulfide, this tick mark sulfide, is in contact with how many zinc ions? So what is the coordination number of a sulfide? What is the coordination number of sulfide? Now zinc ion occupies alternate tetrahedral voids. Zinc ions occupying alternate tetrahedral voids. Correct? So sulfide, zinc ions occupying alternate tetrahedral voids means sulfide is in contact with how many zinc ions? So what is the coordination number of sulfide? That you have to say. What is the coordination number of sulfide? What is the coordination number of sulfide? That point we have to say. Coordination number of sulfide. Sir, do you say coordination number of sulfide is how much? That is one possibility 4, greater than 4, less than 4, or fourth one is we are unable to see. What do you see? What is the coordination number of sulfide? So for that we have shown here, this sulfide is in contact with what tetrahedral voids? Alternate tetrahedral voids. Alternate tetrahedral voids means this zinc ion here one zinc ion. So this sulfide is in contact with how many zinc ions you see? So from that you say coordination number of sulfide. Sir, so you are saying that B option. Sir, we will check that first sulfide ion is in contact with how many tetrahedral voids do you think? Sulfide ions is in contact with how many tetrahedral voids? If you know that, then only you can say regarding this. Sulfide ions is in contact with how many tetrahedral voids? That point we have to see first. Sulfide ions is in contact with how many tetrahedral voids? Then we will see about alternate tetrahedral voids. Then we will say coordination number. Okay. So sulfide ion is in contact with how many tetrahedral voids? That we have to see. Sulfide ions is in contact with how many tetrahedral voids? That if you know, then only we can say. Sir, now we will check this one. First we will see sulfide ion is in contact with how many tetrahedral voids. Sir, now we will see. You are saying that you are saying some answer, whether it is correct or wrong, we will check. Now first we will take sulfide in the face center. Sulfide is there in the face center. It is in contact with how many small cubes? That we will see. Because body center of each small cube is called tetrahedral void. Now at present, this orange is in contact with, as per shown, is in contact with four small cubes. Shall we say? Four small cubes, shall we say? This orange is in contact with four small cubes, shall we say? Sir. Now further we will write. We will draw the lattice, we will go to the lattice. Sir, we will go to the lattice now. Sir, lattice means we will extend. We will extend this one. Let us extend this. Okay, this is one small cube. Now you say that this orange is having how many small cubes? Is in contact with how many small cubes do you say? That you say. This orange is in contact with how many small cubes in a lattice? In a FCC lattice, how many small cubes do you say? So now this orange, see, this orange is in contact with the down four small cubes, up one five. Like this, if you continue, this orange is in contact with how many small cubes?